Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back in. And if you're new here, my name's Zen. I'm going to be playing a lot of Battlefield 6. So if you guys enjoy live streams, guides, tutorials, gameplays, all of that good stuff, be sure to like and subscribe. I'd love to have you come back around for future content. So we're going to be jumping into settings for Battlefield 6 and how you kind of want to preload your game coming this Thursday and weekend for the open beta for Battlefield 6. Of course, the game's not out, so some settings are going to be variable and something you want to fine tune once the game's out. They did say this playtest will be the same version as the final labs playtest or the most recent labs playtest. So I'm assuming it will play the same as that, but you never know with games and how it's actually going to feel or perform. Regardless, we're going to hop into settings and how I have my game ready to go for this Thursday. Also, we're going to jump into Nvidia control panel stuff right now. So to start off, Nvidia control panel, you can right click your desktop, boom. The main things right here in 3D settings, manage 3D settings. I'm just going to scroll through this, and this is how I have my stuff set up. It's basically default. But yeah, that's how I have my control panel. Also, resolution here, you want to make sure you have your monitor that you play the game on selected, the correct resolution, and then make sure you're at the max refresh rate. And then lastly, desktop color settings. Right here at the very bottom, you're going to see this thing called digital vibrance. This is a beautiful way to boost color vibrancy or saturation, as it's more commonly known, in game. Now, just be careful. This is a global setting. So when you close your game out, whether you're working on your computer, editing something, watching Twitch, it's going to stay at 60%. This is a universal setting. So you may want to come back in and turn your colors down. If you do want to run digital vibrance to make your game look more colorful, I would recommend maxing it out at a 15% increase or putting it at 65% maximum. Anything beyond 65%, it's really going to start looking vibrant, arcadey, and fantasy-like because the colors will be so strong, which really work well in games like Apex and stuff. But for a Battlefield style game, I would recommend a 60, 65 maximum, but this is all personal preference. So graphics, color profiles, you can come in here and adjust your colors. I made my friendly color blue, a little bit more vibrant blue. And then squad color, I like on the green like that. So enemy, I made super vibrant red. You could either run red. Another color that would be good is kind of like yellow. Do a gold yellow or just a super bright vibrant yellow or even like a piss green yellow. And this yellow is a really common color for games like Valorant or other shooters. It stands out quite a bit. And everything else, you could just choose what you like for colors. Basically, I'm going to run everything on low because I'm not sure how optimized this build is. I'm assuming it's going to be like what they said, the same build as the most recent labs playtest. So I'm just running everything on low. Brightness 75, again, anything from like 50 to 80 should be good. Sharpness, I like it 80. And then we'll go into advanced here. Resolution scale 100, FPS capped, so I have that set to 163. My max for the monitor is 165, so I just have it a bit below my monitor maximum. Nvidia reflex enabled plus boost. If this feels good, I'll keep it. If it doesn't feel good, I'm just going to turn it off. And I am running DLSS on performance. I play 1440p, so I like running performance for my DLSS. And we'll see. Sometimes DLSS, it's so different in certain games. Some games it's amazing, some games it's fuzzy and terrible. So we'll see how it feels. If it's blurry, I'm just turning it off and sacrificing my frames. We'll see though. Performance overlay, as you can see, if you want that on simple, you get some stuff up here, or you could do advanced. I'm just gonna leave mine on simple. Brightness, I would recommend anywhere from 50 to 80. I'm not too sure, but everyone plays on a different monitor. OLED, TN panels, everyone has a different setup. Camera effects, this is a big one. I basically am turning everything off in here. Motion blur, weapon blur, HUD motion is on right now. I kind of like the HUD motion from like Battlefield 4 and stuff, but we'll see what it's like. I may turn this off. Camera shake amount, minimum for sure. Chromatic aberration, that's like a visual effect. I turn that off. Infantry crosshair projection. So this is like your dynamic or static crosshair. I prefer static crosshairs, so still. Perhaps I will like the dynamic moving crosshair in game to match the moving HUD. We'll see. I may turn this one on. This is really cool. So in audio volumes right here, master volume 60, tinnitus, you can turn this down if you want, and tinnitus pitch, you can also adjust if you want. So here's like the logic for hold or toggle options in game. This is how I have it set up now. Crouch toggle sprint. This is like a logic for if you enter a to sprint while crouched? Are you going to stay crouched, or are you going to go default standing? I just put it on stand. This was also in Battlefield 1, I think. Crouch slide. So this is like if you have multiple binds for crouch, what logic will apply a slide to? I just left it on all. Double tap crouch for sprint slide. So this is kind of cool. Like if you're sprinting, you could double tap your crouch key and you'll perform a slide. So you can have crouch and slide on one key. I'm going to probably have my crouch and slide isolated. So I have this off. And then here's like hold for ADS, hold to steady scope. So you can kind of go through and just adjust it how you like. Probably turn this off. This can get really annoying. It like tells you how to pick up an item or enter a vehicle or something. So I mean, you could just turn both of these off if you want, honestly. Hints, I'll probably end up turning all of these off. So sometimes they can just get in the way and be a little annoying. Again, it's personal preference. All right, so under infantry, this is a big one. This is gonna be like all your aiming settings. And I'm not fully sure what I'm gonna be running. Probably somewhere around 5 to 9 for my mouse aim sensitivity. Also, if you guys wanna get into the decimal values, you just need to use your arrow key, okay? So using your arrow key, you'll plus or minus 0.1. And then in control settings, so this uniform soldier aiming or uniform infantry aiming is definitely something you're going to want to turn on. It basically allows different zoom levels to feel like you have the same ADS coefficient speed. So like if you're using iron sights versus a 6x, it will feel the same. So it just kind of helps a low zoom not feel too fast and high zoom not feel too slow. And it kind of just helps your brain with muscle memory. And then this zoom sensitivity coefficient right here. So this is basically allowing you to choose. If you put it at 0, you're basically saying you want your sensitivity to be 1-to-1, meaning your hip fire and ADS sense is equivalent. Most FPS coaches will say you should do this in FPS games. 1-to-1 sense really is the best, but I'm going to see how it feels. Run mine on 0, or I may run 178 since I run 16:9 monitor. 178 is a good option and kind of scales correctly with the horizontal aspect of this monitor. So default's going to be 133, which is a pretty, I think it's like an industry standard. And I think that's what games like CSGO uses or used, I guess now it's CS2, but I'm going to try 178 or 0 and see which one I like more. And then infantry mouse aim sensitivity, this is just going to be your general sense. So again, I'm probably going to play something like 5 or anywhere from 5 to 9. And if you want to fine tune this more, again, guys, you need to use your arrow keys, and that's how you can adjust by 0.1 plus or minus and get more specific with it. Infantry key binds, here are my key binds. So I like interact on F, enter exit vehicle on F. We'll just go through this. I still have some key binds to lock in. I'm not fully sure on a few things like my gadgets and stuff. Usually gadgets I like running on like Q, X, things like that. So we'll see. One thing to take note of, I like crouch on toggle with C, and then I'm probably going to run my slide on E. We'll see. We'll lock that in a little bit later, but we'll see how that is. I ran my slide on E in 2042. So although the slide is way more mellow in this game. Of course, fire, mouse 1, ADS, mouse 2. I like my reload on mouse 4. A lot of people make fun of me for this one. Check out my G Pro, guys. This thing has a blown out mouse 5, which is my normal reload key. So if any company is watching this and wants to hook me up with a mouse to review and use, I would be more than happy. Melee, we're going to run on V. And yeah, I mean, like I said, I like my primary weapons on hard set 1 through 3, or 1 through 3. I'll probably adjust gadget 1 and 2 here to a different, probably Q and X. And then grenade on G. These are all like laser logic and stuff. I'm just leaving this default for now. Firing mode, I like to toggle firing mode on B. That's just what I'm used to from PUBG. Steady scope, left shift. So this is going to be holding your breath when you're aiming down sight. Just a quick pinky tap, and again, we set it on hold, or excuse me, we set it on toggle earlier, so it's just, you press it once and can release, boom. Toggle scope, I like scroll wheel up, not clicking in on the scroll wheel, but scroll wheel up or down, I like for toggling optic magnification or over to canted sights. So again, that's something I'm used to from PUBG, and that's why I have that set up like that. Modify options, cycle primary and secondary, I have my primary and secondary hard set to 1 and 2, so I just have those unbound. I don't want to use scroll wheel for that. And that's basically my keybinds for now. UI keybinds, so scoreboard, tab, chat on enter. Push to talk bind, I'll probably change this to, I mean, I used to. So if I had this mouse 5, I would have reload on that, and then I always used to run mouse 4 as my push to talk, super easy to press with your thumb. So we'll see, I'll have to figure something out for that. And yeah, this is all just kind of personal preference. Again, the interface and HUD stuff, you can adjust this and modify your HUD quite a bit. I like my kill feed on squads and nearby, because then I know what's happening in the kill feed is happening around me. I can see the players who are around me and what guns they're using. If you don't care about that, you can put it on all to see the whole entire map. Both options are awesome. I just tend to prefer the squad and nearby for Battlefield. Kill feed icons are on. Horizontal HUD padding. So this is like the padding threshold. You see this button right here and then the edge of my screen. So that's called padding. It's like a web design term. And I tend to like my padding on the UI of an arcade shooter kind of large, because then my mini map isn't super far on the edge of my screen. I can just glance over quick and easy, and it's right there. I'm not sure what value is going to look good, but I just have it at 50 right now. I'll probably adjust this more. Minimap size, I like my minimap large. I haven't adjusted most of this. I haven't adjusted much of my minimap settings, but I probably will once I can get a live view of the game and just how the colors, the overlay, the opacity, everything looks. So I'll definitely fine tune this more. Arcade respawn shooters, I like rotating minimap. If I'm playing a BR or Extraction or a Milsim, I definitely am keeping that map true north. But in a respawn game that's fast paced, I think it's just more logical to be looking in a direction with my player, look at my mini map and know left is to the left instead of determining and remembering which way is north. That's just me. And yeah, I mean, everything else here is pretty straightforward. And again, going to be personal preference. Audio, I'm running high dynamic right now, and if that doesn't sound good, I'll just run default mix, because I am running a custom EQ anyways on my game. Audio in the background I have turned off, and then master volume 60, music at 0, I'll probably turn that up to like 10, sound effects 100, commander 60, and then UI sound effects probably 100. Hit indicator, these are hit marker sounds, so depending on how loud they are, how the EQ or how the balancing is, I may just turn these off. I often like no hit marker sounds, so we'll see. Right now I leave it on, and then here's voice chat, all of this stuff. You can customize all of this to your liking. Again, just hover over what it says and it literally tells you what it does, so you guys can fine tune this yourself. And yeah, here's some stereo balance, accessibility stuff, and the in-game music radio. I'm not sure, hopefully this music isn't copyrighted. I'm assuming it's just the Battlefield theme songs, so I'll probably leave these on, turn it down to like 50 or maybe 25. System, so player created content on, command console on for sure, and then here's your streamer mode, anonymous mode, radio music, more mini map stuff. So that's how you can set up your game for now to get ready for launch day of the beta. Now I'll probably do a full settings video once the game has been out and released, but I just wanted to get this out to help you guys preload your game and get ready for Thursday or the weekend that you have access to. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. If this video helped or you like the content, be sure to subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Have a good day.